what was the best class you ever heard of? Like when you were in high school, almost every class except yours was given the best class of the year award. It's okay, it's not your fault either. You wouldn't have cared less for that award, but what if I told you once upon a time the entire class won the Nobel Prize? Sounds like a clickbait, huh? I swear it's not. Like, really. Just watch the video and you'll find it out. You might be knowing this guy, or maybe not. That's Dr. Subramaniam Chandrasekhar, one of the legends who contributed a lot in the fields of astrophysics. So what's the story? Let's understand. Dr. Subramaniam Chandrasekhar used to work closely with his students who were seeking a doctorate in physics, and astrophysics in particular. So in the late 1930s, he was supposed to tutor on a course in astrophysics at the Yerkes Observatory, University of Chicago. But the observatory was 80 miles away from the main campus. Dr. Chandrasekhar was excited and looking forward to it, but to his disappointment, only two students registered for the course. The students were D.D. Lee and C.N. Yang. This was embarrassing for him. Plus, he got demotivated for this, since his colleagues made fun of him as professors of Chicago University took pride in the number of students registered for the course and the obvious, the course itself. It seemed like Dr. Chandrasekhar would cancel the course as the idea of traveling 100 miles for a couple of students was annoying. But he didn't, as he was fond of the subject and did not want to miss an opportunity to teach and explore the subject in depth. So this was a class of two students and ultimately became the smallest class in the university. But this only gave more time for the students and the professor to discuss the course in depth. You might have already guessed what was the result of this, but just in case not, then here it is. In 1957, both D.D. Lee and C.N. Yang went on to win the Nobel Prize in Physics for proving that in a mirror kind of world, the decay rate of objects and antimatter would be pretty much inverted as compared to that of the matter in our world. And then in 1983, Dr. Chandrasekhar was awarded the Nobel Prize as he proposed theories for the development that stars subsequently underwent and for explaining how white dwarf stars are made. Apart from being a Nobel laureate, he is also remembered as the great astrophysicist who strongly influenced the later developments of our understanding of stellar objects like black holes and his remarkable work on Newton's Principia. In 2017, NASA named one of its observatories in the honor of Dr. Chandrasekhar, naming it Chandra X-ray Observatory. Also, he was the nephew of Sir Chandrasekhara Venkata Raman, or C.V. Raman, who was awarded the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1930. So, this is how the entire class did win the Nobel Prize. Told ya, it's not a clickbait. Anyways, that's it for this video. Do let us know that what shower thoughts keep you awake all night and we will make a video on it. See you in the next video, and till then, stay tuned and subscribe if you're new.